Jeanette Rodriguez. Am I pronouncing your first name correctly, Jeanette?
Yes, Janice Rodriguez.
All right. Are you a Harris supporter or a Trump supporter or neither?
I'm a Trump supporter and I am Sarasota, Florida, getting ready for this hurricane. Oh my word.
You should be gone already. I hope you and your family are safe. Did you support Trump in 20 or 16?
Yes, both of them.
Both of them. All right. I'm unmuting Michael Bix and Chris. Guys, you're in charge of this segment. Ask Jeanette some questions. What would you like to ask her?
Well, I have a question for actually the experts, which is when can Kamala sort of turn the page to climate change? Because these two storms are direct, I mean, are related to something that basically Donald Trump denies exists, which is climate change. And
I hope she does that today.
no, not today. Clearly not today, but that's an existential threat.
Yeah, it
And
is. And
I
it's
mean,
and, it, and it's a hard it's a hard one for our most skilled politicians who believe it's an existential threat to win. But to win it in the last month of a campaign with no public visible public record and with people suffering, I think would be a big challenge.
but on the
Could be
other
done,
hand,
but
these two storms, when you look at the experts, I mean, it used to be probably caused by climate change. Now, I mean, basically, these back-to-back storms are being caused by a warmer Gulf of Mexico, which is being caused by climate change. And at some stage, if you're interested in protecting American people, like,
All right, Michael, hold on, hold on.
how do you make that an issue? My question.
Michael's in New Hampshire. Jeanette, what do you feel about climate change being the cause of you having to board up your house and leave?
I'm sorry, I don't believe in climate change. I mean, I'm in Florida, so I just don't believe that. I don't believe in climate change. I mean, it changes all the time. I mean, I just don't. I don't care about that. I really don't.
Denial is a river in Egypt.
Mr.
Sorry.
Simmons, would you like to ask Jeanette the question? Your neighbor to the
Yeah,
south?
I'd have several, but
Yeah.
one question I have for Jeanette is what is it that most troubles you about Kamala?
She's fake. She's scripted. She gives a lot of word salad. And she's from California, for goodness sakes, San Francisco. I mean, how does that not bother anyone?
And so her apparent fakeness bothers you more than Trump's out and out frequent lying and fabricating
But
and insulting?
she lies though. She lies. And the thing about it, what makes me upset, and I'm a Hispanic woman, is that the media, everybody treats the people, American people, like we're idiots. We see it. And that's what makes us even more angry. And now that we have this thing happening, this hurricane happening, and how I mean, it's just, I'm sorry, forgive me, I'm just rambling on.
Do you have
No,
Sorry.
you're not.
You're doing great. You're doing great.
Wait a minute. Do you have children, Jeanette?
Yes, I have, well, four, and I have three grandchildren.
So let me ask you this question as a Latina woman. Which party, when they get in control, is going to make sure that corporate America might hire your brown children? The Republicans or the Democrats?
Well, I want a party that is going to hire the right people. To me, it just doesn't matter. You know, it doesn't matter what somebody has between their legs.
But
I
you
want
know that,
somebody who is,
you do
and if
realize
one of
that,
my kids are not qualified, I don't want them in that job. I mean, this is not the
but
way
you
it is.
do realize that for decades until recently in this country, it didn't matter if you were qualified, it didn't matter whether you were a woman or brown.
It doesn't matter to me. I just, you know, and I think that that's why Hispanics are going, you know, away from. We don't think like that. We think of qualifications. We don't think about women, men. I don't care. You know, I really don't care. And I love a strong man. And Kamala does not give me that.
Are you involved in politics at all? Are you active in politics?
A little. Well, I tell people about it. I talk to my family about it. I, you know, tell people how we feel. My husband. Yeah, we a little bit. Just
Yeah.
yeah,
And
I'm.
where are you back where are you evacuating to?
Well, we're not eva we are we're not evacuating, so we are
Do you live in zone three?
zone C. Zone A and B are evacuating.
I meant C. Sorry.
I'm at C, so, you know. Did they issue, my husband's just telling me, did they just issue us an evacuation? Issued us an evacuation.
So,
but
so where will you go if you need to go?
I don't know. We can't. I mean, everybody's just trying to leave and it's just chaos out there. Our home is, we're pretty safe here. We did it for Ian. I mean, it's okay. We're okay. We're survivors. But yes, I just wanted to say thank you to you guys and to you also for, you know, for this site.
All right. Well, we're great. How'd you find out about the morning meeting?
Well, I used to watch you on MSNBC and then Newsmax. And then I go on YouTube because I hate the media. So when I saw that you just popped out and I'm like, oh, my goodness, I was really excited. So thank you so much.
All right. Well, we're glad to have you here. We hope you're safe. I don't want to override your governor or your mayor, but I'd recommend you think about evacuating.
I don't know. Thank you. God bless you.
Okay. Thank you for joining. Appreciate it. We're going to sneak one more person in. Floria, welcome. Tell folks where you are, who you're supporting, and what's on your mind, please.
Hi, my name is Floria Graham, and I'm from New York, and I'm going to be voting for Donald Trump.
Somehow I knew you were going to say that. You live in New York City?
I do. I live in Harlem, born and raised.
Just because if I call on anybody but Chris Simmons or Michael Bix, they're all for Donald Trump today for some reason. Have you voted for Donald Trump in the past?
I certainly have.
Yeah. And how do you think he's going to do amongst your friends and family?
Most of my family are registered Democrats, and they voted Republican for Trump, and they're going to do it this time as well. I grew up in, as most Black people do, I grew up with
Hold on, we've lost your audio.
Oh, sorry.
At least I have. Okay, you're back now. Go ahead.
Okay, they're not the party of my parents anymore. They just are not. They've taken, in my opinion, and many people in my circle, and many people in the Black community, were simply not pleased with the Democratic Party. And to me, they come across as a threat, and they are very arrogant about it. You have Democratic supporters that are literally coming on television trying to chip away at our First Amendment rights. That's a threat. And it's just this, they're the ones who constantly use race to bait for votes. I just don't see what Kamala Harris, it's not even just a Democratic Party. I mean, Kamala Harris, it's the Democratic Party. I stopped voting for Democrats after Barack Obama. And I didn't even vote for him the second time.
Do you see Donald Trump as an inspirational leader or just against the Democrats?
I am voting Republican as a protest vote against the Democrats. I was registered as a Democrat and I changed my registration to Republican only because as an independent in New York, you're not allowed in any of the primaries. But I just didn't want any association with him. As for him being an inspiration, I think the Black community, including myself, are just frustrated with election period after election period, Black people voting as a bloc for this party. And ultimately, it seems like nothing. It's nothing. And then, you know, we're told, shut up. It's horrible the way the media and the way entertainers talk to belittle Black people for wanting to have a choice, for voicing wanting to have a choice.
Floria, is there anybody in the Democratic Party who talks about race in a way you respect and appreciate, or you can't think of anybody who does that?
I can't think off the back of my head. No, they're all lockstep in the same way that we should, and we need to vote blue no matter who. And, you know, you can't say that we're not a monolith, but you want us to operate and vote as one. It just doesn't make any sense. I mean, even when they approach Black people, it's never with policies that are substantive that will help us economically or socially. It's always some the day or statue or something that is non-tangible to us. Black people are at the bottom. That's just the truth. I myself, you know, I did not suffer during all of this. I noticed that the groceries did go up, but I'm in a position where I could, you know, afford it, but I can't say that for most Black people that I'm in contact with. For my family, fortunately enough, we don't, you know, it hasn't affected us the way we see other people, but has it affected? I just don't see the Democratic Party as beneficial. They, to me, it's like a swap. They have become the party of war. It just doesn't make any sense to me. This whole thing about abortion, it's the abortion, the January 6th, it's becoming tone deaf. No one is even listening to this anymore. You want us to vote about abortions and a January 6th over our wallets.
What do you like most about Vice President Harris? What do you find most appealing about her as a public official?
Nothing. I honestly think she's dangerous to Black people based on her record in California as a prosecutor. She was jailing mothers for truancy. She was locking people up and holding them in prison after their time to fight fires. And it's her whole history, especially with Black people in California, has just been whitewashed like it never happened, but it's in black and white. No, I can't consciously think to vote for her. And many Black people I know said the same thing. They would rather not vote or vote down ballot than to vote for her. They find her to be dangerous.
I want to ask you one more question, and I'm going to open it up to if other folks want to. And I appreciate everything you're saying. Super interesting, and glad you joined us. Chris pointed out the other day, Donald Trump, in a television interview, pretended not to know who David Duke was, or at least seemed to. He's the leader of the birther movement to try to use race to convince people that Barack Obama was ineligible to be president. Does that stuff give you any pause about having him in the White House regarding race, or you don't think those are big deals, or just how do you factor then to how you think about supporting it?
It's not that I don't factor it in. Listen, Donald Trump is of a certain age. To say that he may not have some kind of racial biases in him, my parents did when they were, you know, and they were older than him. But this whole idea that like he's the only one on the ticket with these ideas is ridiculous. Joe Biden has a rich history of racism, a rich history that's documented. So for me to say I can't vote for Donald Trump would be the same for me to say I can't vote for Joe Biden. The one thing we can say is Donald Trump never enacted laws that harmed Black people. You cannot say that about Joe Biden. He was proud to say he orchestrated the 3-strike rule.
Yeah. Chris, you want to ask a question?
Hey, Mark, I apologize. I have to... Yeah. Great conversation. I just have to jump off. Yeah. So see you guys.
Okay, back. Sean, sorry. All right, Sean, thank you. Sorry to go over time.
I'd like to know where your grandparents are from.
All of my family is originated from the South.
Your grandparents were born in the South?
My grandparents were born in the South. And my grandfather, God rest his soul, was a sharecropper. I'm very sure before then, his father was a slave.
And your view that many Black people feel the same way, you do realize that Trump got 8% of the Black vote last time. What do you think he's going to get this time?
I said many people in my circle, what I talked to.
Oh, okay. Well, what's your guess? What 4% of Black people overall do you think he's going to get this time?
He's going to get a greater amount than 8%.
You think it'll be over 15?
I'm not sure about that, but it's going to be greater than what it is. If it's only for a protest against the Democratic Party, if it's only for protest.
So one last, I'll have a question for you. What will be your reaction when at some later point I say, that if Trump gets less than 15% of the black vote, he will be the president of white America, but not black America.
Tell me what president hasn't been the president of white America, including Barack Obama.
Yeah, but Barack Obama got a lot of the black vote too, didn't he?
Yes, because we are stuck on imagery, and that's it.
And that's maybe it. We're stuck on people who don't discriminate in their housing facility against renting Barack the black
Obama,
vote.
Barack Obama discriminated against black people. A lot of black people were disgruntled during his presidency.
You think Barack Obama discriminated against black people?
He ignored black people. He did, okay. And that's how many black people feel. At least many young black people feel that way.
Well, not enough to get Trump more than 8% last time. I guess young ones must not be voting.
Well, we'll see this time.
Okay, we'll see.
I'm almost sure he's going to get more than 8%.
All right. Chris, thank you. Gloria, how'd you find out about two-way in the morning meeting?
It came through the algorithm, but I've always followed you when you were on television.
All right. We appreciate you joining and sharing all thank that with you. Us. And I love listening to Chris talk respectfully to younger people who are supporting Donald Trump.
I appreciate it.
Chris never, except for the loss of the poker face on a previous comment, Chris is a mainstay here. Chris, thank you for joining.